Namaste to one and all. This is Margaret, Science at Your Tips. So today we'll see one small topic in our Motion and Time of 7th class science textbook. Pictorial representation of the concept or idea. So we know already that if you are showing any picture to the children and explaining, it will be understandable very easily. Instead of explaining simply like that blindly, if you are showing some picture for them and based on that if you are explaining, then they are able to understand it very clearly. So, here in our Motion and Time, we are able to explain to the children about the concept by using a very special thing here, that is a pictorial representation we are seeing, that will be done here in the form of graphs. So, here these graphs, whatever are there, three different types of graphs we are going to use. One is bar graph, and one more is pie graph, and the other one is line graph. So these are the three different types of the graphs we are going to show to the children in our lesson Motion and Time. So coming to the bar graph, instead of going directly into the topic graph, we will take some data here. Anyway, if you have to construct any graph, means we should have some data. Based on that data only, we are going to show the graph for the children. So here I am taking some data here. That is, in our class, 36 children are there. In our 7th class, in that particular section, 36 children are there. These 36 children are coming to the school by using different vehicles. Some of them will not use a vehicle. Directly they are coming, means by walk only they are coming. So let us take the data, let us collect the data, how these children are coming to the school regularly. Okay, so here I will say that 4 children are there here in our 7th class. From 36 children, 4 students are there who come to the school by walk, because they are very nearer to the school, their home is very nearer, they will come by walk. And some of the students are there, 6 students are there, which are coming by bike. Their father will come and they will drop there and go by bike. And some of the students are there here, 8 students are there here, which are coming to the school by their own vehicle, car. And some of the students are there here, those students, 16 students are there, who are coming by auto. Okay, now altogether how many children we got? 16 plus 8, 24 plus 6, 30 plus 4, 34. The remaining 2 children are there. These 2 children are coming by the bus. So these are the different vehicles, and even by walk also the students are coming to the school regularly. Now, based on this data, we are going to construct a bar graph. Now, let us take this bar graph here. What we are going to do is, here also we will have the x-axis and y-axis. Now let us write construct these bars. Let us write the things whatever we have here. Let us write here on the x-axis. Now I am writing here whichever is having least, that I wanted to write at the starting. Bus. 2 students are coming by bus. And after that, by walk, 4 students are coming to the school. And by bike, 6 students are coming, and by car, 8 students are there, by auto, 16 students are there. Now I have written here on x-axis. Now just to show the difference between these all, just to draw one small dot or put a dot there, so that while construction of the bar graph, it will be easy for you. And after that, what you do is, okay, right. So we have written bus, walk, bike, car and auto on this axis. Now let us take this y axis. Here we are going to write the number of the students. So actually we have to make some scale here in that graph. What we are going to do is, I will write 2, 4 like that, multiples of 2 I wanted to write on y axis. So I will write here 2, 4, exactly with the scale we have to write. Here I am writing just like that, but we have to use a scale while writing this on Otherwise, anyway, on the graph paper, we'll have that division of that. So, based on that, we can write. So, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, like this we have to write. And after that, what you do here, two members are coming by bus. So, just draw one box here, one bar, here it is over. You can give a color for this, or otherwise, you can draw some other lines. So that you can understand, this is a graph, this is a bar in the graph which is showing the students who are attending the school by bus. Now, by walk, how many students are coming to the school? Four members. From the data given, four members. So before four, just to put a point, and here you construct this by draw using the scale. Okay, by walk two students are coming here. So to just to show the differentiation, I'm drawing some dots here. And after that, by bike, how many students are attending to the school? Six members. So before six, put a dot. And just to complete this, in this form, and just to show the difference, draw some lines. Or otherwise, you can color these by green, blue, yellow, different colors, so that you can easily identify this. Okay. And by car, how many students are attending to the school? Eight members. So before eight, just to put a dot. And complete this also in the form of a bar. Okay, and you can draw some lines or you can give colors for this. Better you give colors for this so that easily you can understand the concept. And by auto, how many students are attending? 16 students are attending. So before 16, I'll just rub this word so that you can understand the graph clearly. So here 16 students are attending to the school. They are coming regularly to the school by using auto. So what I'll do is, with the help of the scale, we are going to draw one bar here showing that these all students are attending the school by using auto. So this is the completed one. This is showing the number of students who are coming to the school by bus, by walk, by bike, by car, and also by auto. Okay, you can give some other shape also for this, because already dots are completed. Let us show some stars or some into marks like that. Anything you can do. Better you give some color for this graph. So like this you can draw the graph. That is for bar graph. Right. Now shall we go for the pie graph? Here in pie graph, what we'll do is we'll take a pie. Pie in the sense here, anyway we are unable to draw the spherical shape on the board. It's not a two-dimensional, it is a three-dimensional one. So how to do that? Pie graph, how to do that on the wall, means on the board. Here we have to draw some circle. I'm taking the same data, whatever is given for the bar graph. For drawing the pie graph, what we'll do is, we'll draw some circle here. And you know already that in this circle, total number of degrees, the total angle, whatever is there in the circle, it will be 360 degrees. So what we'll do is, each degree we are considering like one student. So let us make this as four parts. It will be easy for us to complete it easily, because each part will show us nine students. 9 9 9 9 shows 36 students, right? So based on this, let us complete the pie graph. Now here we have 36 students, in that 4 are attending to the school by walk, we said. So exactly in between, if you are doing, it will be showing like 4.5. So what I want to do is, I will just draw like this. So it is showing the 4 students. I will say that these students are there who are attending to the school by walk. So remaining 5 students are there. So just I will draw a line here showing that this is showing 6 students who are attending to the school by bike. You can draw some colors here, or otherwise same like that. You can draw the lines or some other dots, anything. You can draw blue, red, different bright colors you can draw here. Okay. So by bike, how many students are attending here? 6 students. Next, by car. So what you have to do for finding out the number 8 here, you are already 6 completed, 4 completed, so 10 completed here. Here remaining 8 are there. So 8 six are completed here, so here 8 are there. So directly we can write this as car. Okay, so by car these many students, 8 students are attending. So let us write this number also. By bike 6 students, by walk how many students here? 4 students. Next, by bus also 2 members are attending to the school, no? So what we'll do here, we'll just draw one line here. Use a scale every time, children. I'm just drawing like this without using the scale. You use the scale and do it. So by bus here 2 students are attending. So remaining will be our 16 members who are coming by auto. Now after drawing this full, once again you check the number. 2 plus 4, 6 plus 6, 12 plus 8, 20 plus 16, 36. So 36 students are completed here. You can give different colors here. Blue, red, yellow, green, some other purple color, violet color, like that. Different bright colors use here so that you can understand this concept very clearly. So by using bar graph and also by using pie graph, we are able to construct this graphs. We are able to understand the concept very easily. Now once let us check what is this line graph is. Everyone understood these two graphs, children? Bar graph and pie graph. We'll go for line graph. Now here we have line graph. Here we are going to draw one graph between distance and time. Time I have taken here on x-axis, and here the scale also we can write. Means here every division we have taken it as 1 hour. Here time we are going to measure in hours, and distance we are going to measure in kilometers. So y-axis we have taken this distance, and on x-axis we have taken the time. Now here we are going to draw the line graph. Now for drawing any graph anyway, we have to know what is the data given. We have to see about the data, means for every 1 hour how much distance is covered. Based on that we are going to draw the graph, not simply like that. So let us see here, first 1 hour, some vehicle is there which is able to cover, first 1 hour it is able to cover some 10 kilometers. Because of heavy traffic, it was able to cover only 10 kilometers. And second hour, it was able to cover 20 kilometers. And third hour, it was able to cover 30 kilometers. Like that, so on. Okay. Now, what we'll do here, first hour, 10 kilometers is covered. So before 10, 9, 1, use a scale here. By using a scale, before 10 exactly, you put a dot. You put a dot before 10 exactly, and it should come before 1 also. So wherever they are matching together, there you put the dot. Then, second hour 20 kilometers are covered. So before 2 and before 20, you should see that it should be opposite to 20 here on y axis and opposite to 2 on x axis. Put a dot. Then, before 3 and before 30, here you put a dot. Now after that, what to do? Just to draw some line which is going to join these three. Use a scale, I said. So by using the scale, you are going to get a straight line. As I have not used, may come somewhat here and there. Exactly, if you are using the scale, you are going to get it exactly on the straight line only you are going to get it. See, here I have to put the dot actually. Here before 20 and also before 2. And before 30 here on y-axis and before 3 on x-axis. So like this, we have drawn one line. Before that, what we have done, we kept some dots here which are showing that every 1 hour 10 kilometers are covered. First hour 10 kilometers, second hour 20 kilometers, third hour 30 kilometers, like that. So this data, whatever is given for it, it is showing that the vehicle, whatever is there, it is traveling with the uniform speed. So we can say this motion is a uniform motion. If it is not covered equal distance, before also we have seen, if any vehicle or if any object is not covering equal distance in equal intervals of time, we say that it is under non-uniform motion. But here, whatever the data is given, this is based on the uniform motion. So this is about the graph, children. Bar graph, pie graph, and also line graph.